Yeah, good evening, guys. You're able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
We'll get started. So today we'll be practicing some problems based on the concepts that we have already completed. So, yeah. So we'll get started. So first we will do some problems which are based on the refractive index and apparent shift. Sure. So what answer for the how to solve the first problem guys, right? So there is a ray of light whose frequency is 5 into 10 power 14 hertz, which is passed through a liquid. The wavelength of the light measured inside the liquid is thought to be 450 to 10 power minus 9 meter, that is 450 nanometer. Calculate the refractive index of the liquid. So basically, how is refractivity is defined as speed of light in vacuum to the speed of the light in the given medium. Correct? So how to solve? First problem, mu is equal to c divided by v. C already 3 into 10 power 8. But how will you write v in terms of frequency and wavelength? Frequency into wavelength is going to give you the speed. So 3 into 10 power 8 divided by 5 into 10 power 14 into 450 into 10 power minus 9. So it goes 10 power 6. So 5 is 0.6. So can you calculate and tell me in terms of fraction? Guys, make it fast. Tell me in terms of fraction. One by 25. Here, 0.6 divided by 4 cubed. So 0.6 into 10 power 3, 600 divided by 4 cubed. 4 by 3 is 150 level. So you get 4 by 3. Correct? Guys, did you get it? Those who are online, did you get 600 by 450? They say yes or no. So 3 divided by 0.5 is 0.6 divided by 450 into 10 power minus 3. This will go to the numerator. So 600 divided by 450, cancel it. In 15, it goes 4 times. This goes 3 times. 4 divided by 3 is 1.33, which is the refractive index of water. Okay. Second, so there is a light of wavelength 6000 angstrom in air. It enters into a medium with refractive index of 1.5. What will be the wavelength of the light in that medium? Try to solve it. What is the relationship between refractive index and wavelength? Inversely proportional to wavelength, correct? So write it down. So refractive index of medium by refractive index of air will be equal to wavelength in air divided by wavelength in medium. So refractive index of medium with respect to air is 1.5 is equal to lambda a over 6000 divided by lambda in the medium is what we need to find. So 6000 divided by 1.5. 1.5 can write as 3 by 2. So 2000 into 2. 4001. Yeah. So that's the answer. Third, the refractive index of glass is 1.5 and that of water is 1.3. If the speed of light in water is 2.25 into 10 power 8 meters per second, what is the speed of light in glass? They are inversely proportional. So do it fast. So my suggestion would be convert everything in terms of fraction and then do it. 1.5 is 3 by 2. 1.33 is 4 by 3. How much is the answer? So did you get the answer? 1.95 to 10 power 8. You're still doing? Okay, that's fine. It is inversely proportional. So you will get the answer. Fourth one. There is a ray of light which passes through a plane boundary separating two media, whose refractive indices are 3/2 and 4/3. If the ray of light travels, the ray of light travels from medium one to medium two at an angle of incidence 30 degrees. What is the angle of refraction? So it is based on Snell's law. Apply it. So how will you apply Snell's law? I told you another mu one sin I is equal to sin R. Do that way. So 3/2 sin 30 is equal to 4/3 sin R. So sin 30 is half. So 3/4 is equal to 4/3 times sin R. So sin R will be equal to 9/16. So sin R will be 9/16. R will be equal to sin inverse of 9/16. Okay. If the ray travels from medium 2 to medium 1 at the same angle of incidence, in this case, what will be the angle of refraction? So what will happen? You need to swap the values. So you will have 4/3 into sin 30 will be equal to 3/2 sin R. 3/2 sin R. Do and see. Will it be the same? Obviously, no. Guys, are you able to understand? Why is no one responding? Are you guys clear?
Yes, sir.
Good. Hemant, Gayatri, Harini, Purnashri, everybody clear? Purnashri, Sashank, Satyapriya, Shipra, Swatiha, and Vinisha. You need not write in terms of degrees and minutes. So there is a rectangular glass slab which is at the bottom of a beaker. Okay. A ray of light incident on the water surface at an angle of 50 degrees, let's make it 60 for the time being. 60 degrees passes through water into glass. Calculate the angle of refraction of the glass. Given that mu for water is 4/3 and that for glass is 3/2. So try to draw a diagram and see. There is a rectangular glass slab and there is a beaker which contains water. Okay. So first draw the beaker with water, and at the bottom there is a rectangular glass slab that is placed. Now light is passed through whom? A light is incident on the water surface at an angle 60 degrees that passes through water into glass. So this is a slightly tricky question. 1 minute. Yeah. So it is something like this. Rectangular glass slab rests at the bottom of the cup of water. A ray of light is incident on the water surface. On the water surface. So water surface is somewhere over here at an angle of, I told you, to 60 degrees. So ray is traveling from rarer to denser medium. So this goes something like this. So if I call this as R, then this will also be R. What are they asking? Calculate the angle of refraction inside the glass. Correct? So find R and then again go to this one. So refractive index of water is 4/3 and the refractive index of glass is 3/2. So applying, how many times? Logic is very simple, okay? If you need to apply Snell's law, the number of times refraction is undergone is equal to the number of times we need to apply Snell's law. So when you apply Snell's law at the first boundary, what will you get? 4 by 3 into sine 60 is equal to, sorry, I made a mistake. What is it? 1 by 3 into sine 60 is equal to, so not 1 by 3, 1 into sine 60 is equal to 4 by 3 into sine r. Let this be 1. Similarly, 4 by 3 into sine r is equal to 3 by 2 into sine r dash. Okay, so 4 by 3 sine r, 4 by 3 sine r. So sine 60 will be dash. Sine 60 is 3 by 2 is equal to 3 by 2 times sine r dash. Cancel this. So sine r dash is equal to 1 by root 3 and r dash will be equal to sine inverse of 1 by root 3. This is clear? So this is what they are expecting. Please make a note. Done. We go to the next one. So this one is based on the concept of lateral shift. The ray of light is instant at an angle of 60 degrees. So I is equal to, write it up, I is equal to 60 degrees on one face of rectangular glass slab of thickness 0.1. T is equal to 0.1 meters an hour. And refractive index of 1.5. Mu is equal to 1.5. Calculate the lateral shift produced. Yesterday we derived the formula. Look at it. So T sine I into inner formula. Look at it and then. So wrong book. So I think it is T sine I into 1 minus cos I divided by root of mu square minus sin square I. This T sine I into 1 minus cos I divided by root of mu square minus sin square I. Clear? So application part, you can do it. We'll look at the next problem. The apparent depth of an object at the bottom of a tank filled with a liquid of refractive index 1.3 is 7.7. So write it down. Apparent depth is 7.7 centimeter. Refractive index is 1.3. What is the actual depth? So what is the relation, guys? Refractive index is real depth to apparent. So the formula is apparent depth is equal to real depth divided by mu. This is the actual formula. Now rearrange it, you'll get the answer. So mu times, so logic is very simple. Multiply 1.3 and 7.7. That is going to give the answer. So 13/7 is somewhere around 9.1. That's what is given. 10.01 is the answer. Okay. But this is an important problem, okay? So please Remember this. Next. So last question from this concept, please make a note. The velocity of light in glass is 2 × 10⁸ meters per second, and that in air is 3 × 10⁸ meters per second. By how much would an ink dot appear to be raised when covered by a glass plate of 6 cm thickness? Real depth is 6 cm. Very good. Refractive index. That is 1.5. But here the question is tricky. Right? By how much would an ink dot appear to be raised? You have to subtract it from the real depth. So 6 minus something. Calculate and see how much are you getting. This was sleeping, I guess. Hey, the people are there, huh? Online guys, respond. So did you understand how to do the 8th one? Correct. So read the question. Sometimes if it is MCQ, they will give you 4 also and confuse you. Okay. Do the 9th one then. There is a mark which is made on the bottom of a beaker and microscope is focused on it. Okay. The microscope is raised through 1.5 cm. To what height water must be poured into the beaker to bring the mark again to the focus? Given that the refractive index of water is 4/3. So what are the, did you understand the question? So when the mark is made at the bottom of the beaker, the beaker is empty. So at that point, what they did, they used a microscope and focused on the dot. Now what are they doing? The microscope is raised to 1.5 cm. When it is raised, it is going to get defocused. So when it is defocused, to bring back the focus again, there are two options. One is adjust the microscope, or else pour water and make as if the dot has moved upwards. So they are asking how much height should the water be poured so that the focus is automatically reached. So how you do? So they ask what should be the height. What should be the height to which it should be poured? Real depth minus apparent depth. So real depth alone. Real depth is the height to which the liquid should be poured. Apparent depth is real depth by mu. That should be equal to how much? 1.5. Logic for either. They wouldn't understand. Dot is made. You focus with the microscope. Okay, you got the dot. So இதுக்கும் இதுக்கும் நடுவில் தேர் இஸ் அ ஃபிக்ஸ்டு டிஸ்டன்ஸ் அட் விச் திஸ் மைக்ரோஸ்கோப் இஸ் ஏபிள் டு ஃபோக்கஸ் தட் ஆர்டர். இப்போ மைக்ரோஸ்கோப் வந்து ஹவர் சார்ஜ் ஷிஃப்டட் 1.5 சென்டிமீட்டர். அப்போ திஸ் டாட் ஆல்சோ ஷுட் கெட் லிட்டரலி ஷிஃப்டட் பை 1.5 சென்டிமீட்டர் ஸோ தட் த சேம் ஃபோக்கஸ் இஸ் அட்டைன்ட். கரெக்டா? அப்போ நீ தண்ணி ஒரு போரிங் தட் லிக்விட், you need to pour it in such a way that real depth should be adjusted in such a way that this dot is getting shifted in the upward direction by what value? 1.5. idu real depth, idu apparent depth, so this shift should be 1.5. so real depth minus apparent depth should be equal to 1.5. that is the meaning of the question. Do it. So what are they asking? They are asking you what is the real depth. எவ்வளவு ஹைட்டா தண்ணி ஊத்தணும் வாட்டர் ஒன்லி, ரைட்? வாட்டர் ஃபிஃப்டீன் இல்ல 1.3. தட்ஸ் இட். ஒன் ஈக்குவேஷன் ஒன் அண்ட் ஒன் சால்வ். தேர் இஸ் நோ ஹிடன் இன்ஃபர்மேஷன், ஜஸ்ட் க்வெஸ்சன் இஸ் டிஸ்கட். அவ்வளவுதான். பட் ஆர் யூ கன்வின்ஸ்ட் வித் தி லாஜிக் ஐ கேவ் யூ? யூ ஆர் ஏபிள் டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட், விஷுவலைஸ் இட், ரைட்? So for the ninth one, we need to do it like this. Real depth minus apparent depth is equal to 1.5. Apparent depth is real depth divided by mu. Appa real depth veli eduthutama into 1 minus 1 by mu is equal to 1.5. Now find out the real depth. So 1 minus 1 by mu, da mu is how much? 4/3. Appa 3/4 aidu. 1 minus 3/4 is 1/4. So real depth is equal to 1.5 into 4, which is 6. Understood? It's a good problem. சரியா? So these are all the concepts that are based on refractive index and real depth and apparent depth. Now we can move on to the next part that we have already discussed, that is refraction and total internal reflection. Shall we start? So look at the first one, which is a very, very simple problem. So what is the answer? Find the value of critical angle for a material of refractive index, root b. So refractive index is given as root b. So for you to find the critical angle will it exist in the denser medium or the rarer medium? Denser to rarer, but to that this concept is applicable. So that root b is the refractive index of denser medium. So rarer medium, since they didn't give anything, it can be taken to be air. So now apply the formula. Draw the diagram. First one other one I'll explain. So in the orange term, denser medium, the refractive index is root 3. Here it is 1. So what do you mean by critical angle? If I take this as C, this will be 90 degrees. So root 3 into sin C will be equal to 1 into sin 90. அப்போ 1 on 1. So sin C will be equal to 1/2. So sin C is 1/√3 means sin inverse of 1/√3 is what is the critical angle. We don't need to solve that. We can leave it as sin inverse of 1/√3. Right? So can you try the next one? Calculate the speed of light in a medium whose critical angle is 30 degrees. Slightly twisted C. So whenever you need a problem, whenever you need a value for speed of light, indirectly with respect to ray optics, you need to calculate refractiveness. That is the idea. So yeah, calculate whatever. Do it fast. So using the critical angle concept, find the refractive index. I already got the answer. What is the answer? Refractive index is 2. Refractive index is 2, then the speed of light will be 1.5. It is 1.5 into 10 power 8. I don't know what others are doing. Sine inverse of 1 by mu is 30. So mu will be equal to 2 and mu is equal to C by V. V will be equal to C divided by V, which is 1.5 into 10 power 8. Next one. The velocity of light in a liquid is 1.5 into. Oh, sorry. The velocity of light in a liquid is 1.5 into 10 power 8 meters per second, and in air it is 3 into 10 power 8 meters per second. If the ray of light passes from liquid into air, calculate the critical angle. Draw the ray diagram. So logic is very simple. Whenever they ask the question related to critical angle, what are we supposed to do? Light has to travel from denser to rarer. Now look at both the values. Which one is denser medium? 1.5 into 10 power 8. Is denser because the speed is less. This is 3 into 10 power 8. If the ray of light passes from liquid into air, calculate the critical angle. So, simple as well, if the speed of light in this medium is 1.5 into 10 power 8, what is going to be its refractive index? 2. If the speed of light in a medium is 3 into 10 power 8, what is its refractive index? 1. So, light is going like this. Critical angle is what you need to calculate. Now apply Snell's law. That's it. 2 sine C is equal to 1. So C will be 30 degrees. Fourth one. Determine the direction in which a fish underwater sees the setting sun and refractive index of water is 3.33. So whenever they ask direction in physics, it means angle. So direction in which the fish under the sea, the fish under water sees the setting sun, refractive index of water is 1.33. Good. So the fish is in which medium? Denser or rarer? Denser. So sine c is equal to 1 by mu. Correct? Mu is 1.33. 1.33 is 4 by 3. Sine c is equal to 3 by 4. Sine inverse 3 by 4 is the answer. Sine inverse 3 by 4 is the answer for this one. Fifth one. Determine the critical angle for a glass air surface. So determine the critical angle for glass air surface. If the ray of light is incident in the air on surface, is deviated to 50 degrees when the angle of incidence is 40 degrees. Okay. So let me do this problem I show. This is a tricky question and a good one. So they are using many words like deviated, are they are using. Let's try to understand what they are trying to say. What is this? When light is incident on the air, incident in air on the surface. Incident in air on the surface. Okay. So there is a glass air surface. What is it? It's a glass air surface. If the ray of light which is incident in air on the surface is deviated to 50 degrees and the angle of incidence is 30 degrees. Meaning another. So it is incident in air. So in air, I changed it to 30, correct? So this would be 30 degrees. This should have been the actual path. What do you mean by deviated? It is bending towards the normal. So either 50 now. So what will we do? Refractive index is what we will calculate, mu. is the refractive index 1. So sine 30 is equal to mu times sine 50. So mu will be equal to this is normal. This is 30. Ah, that is normal. This is a normal. No? This is also 15. Okay, 30 length 15 point 8 is 15 only, sir. I still calculated from normal only. This is the refracted ray, and this is the normal. So sine 30 is half divided by sine 40 sine of 45 minus 15. So you calculate the value. Once you know the value, they are asking the critical angle. So sine inverse of 1 by mu. So that will be sine inverse of sine 15 degrees divided by sine 30 degrees. Right. Try to do the sixth one. A glass slab is immersed in water. Find the critical angle, that is not 1.33. Find the critical angle at glass water interface given the refractive index of glass is 1.5, the refractive index of water. Do it fast. So draw the ray diagram, draw the diagram, then you will get more clarity. Sine inverse 2 by 3. Check one. 2 by 3 or 8 by 9. So, glass water, glass is denser, water is rarer. So, sine C is equal to this divided by this. 4 by 3 divided by 3 by 2. So, 2 malapadon. So sine C is equal to 8 by 9, C will be sine inverse of 9. So sine C is equal to 8 by 9, so C will be sine inverse of 8 by 9. Seventh one. The critical angle of incidence in glass slab placed in air is 45 degrees. What will be the critical angle when it is immersed in water of refractive index 1.3? So calculate first refractive index of glass slab. What do you think you will get? So shortcut, sine 45 is how much? Take the reciprocal. Root 2 is the answer. Okay. So the critical angle of incidence in glass slab is 45 degrees. So critical angle is 45 means refractive index will be. Mu is equal to 1 by sine 45. So root 2, what will be the critical angle when it is immersed in water of refractive index 1.3? Now you can do. So root 2 into sine C is equal to root 2 into sine C will be equal to 1 by. Correct. 1.4 by 3. 4 by 3 then. So root 2 into sine C will be equal to 4 by 3. So sine C will be equal to 4 divided by 3 root 2. That's it. That's it. We'll do one last problem and we'll wind up. 8-1. A ray of light is incident on a horizontal surface of glass slab, make it 60. At 60 degrees, just grazes the adjacent vertical surface after refraction. Calculate the critical angle and refractive index of the glass. Did you understand the question? Read it carefully. Incident on a horizontal, so first draw glass slab. So when you draw the glass slab, there's something like this. So there is a glass slab. A ray of light is incident on the horizontal surface of the glass slab at an angle of 60 degrees, after which it bends. It bends, and this time it is bending in such a way that it is going and hitting. What are they saying? Just grazes the adjacent vertical surface after refraction. So after refraction, generally what do we do? That is meaning in it. So this is the horizontal part. The refraction is taking place in such a way that this ray is going and hitting the adjacent vertical surface. At this surface, it is hitting at an angle C so that it just grazes along the surface. Did you understand? Now read the question, you will understand it better. Ray of light incidence on the horizontal surface of the glass slab at a 70-16 inch change just grazes whom? The adjacent vertical surface after refraction. Calculate the critical angle. At the vertical surface, there is critical angle. So the vertical surface, if you draw the normal, so this is how it works. Okay, then what you are supposed to do is this 60 now, you have to calculate this angle. Okay, so let me call this as mu. So if this is C, this is a normal, this is a normal, this will be 90. How much will this be? 90 minus C. If I apply Snell's law at this point, what am I going to get? Sine 60 is equal to mu times sine of mu times cos C. If I apply Snell's law at this point, what will I get? Mu times sin C is equal to 1. Correct? So sin C is equal to 1 by mu. Appa cos C evlo irukum? So sin 60 is equal to mu into cos C square, I will write it as root of 1 minus 1 by mu square. So it will become root of mu square minus 1. Yeah, mu and mu are the denominator, we get cancelled. Sin 60 is root 3 by 2. Square on both the sides. 3 by 4 is equal to mu square minus 1, which implies mu square is equal to 1 plus 3 by 4, which is going to give you 7 by 4. So mu square up mu alone. 7 by 2 is the answer for this. Yeah, make a note of that. Guys, you are able to understand? Is everyone clear with what I mentioned? So that's it for today from my side. Revise all the topics. Okay. Monday we'll be starting with refraction and spherical surface. Okay, that is a slightly tricky part. So revise all these. I'm assuming that you should have given a confidence. Problems are easy, right? So Monday we'll start with refraction and spherical surface. Maximum in 6 days we'll complete this one. There's a very big chapter, this one, and ray optics. After that, we go very fast. Who could have to each chapter? Okay, so that's it. So, any other doubts? Yeah, right? Guys, those who are online, any doubts? Okay, we'll wind up then.